think you need to define torture. The fact that he has anoxic encephalopathy or brain damage caused by the lack of oxygen to the brain, we don't know what the root cause of that is. There's a couple of ways that you can get that. So you either have to discontinue blood flow to the brain or stop breathing. And what caused either one of those possible events, we wouldn't know. I mean, could that have been torture at the time? We don't know. We don't have enough information about what happened to Otto at that initial insult to draw any concrete conclusions. We believe that for somebody who's been bedridden for more than a year, that his body was in excellent condition, his skin was in excellent condition, and we didn't see any evidence of decubiti or bed sores. Physically, as far as wounds, there were a few small scars that we documented. There was one that we really couldn't explain for medical instrumentation, which some of the other scars we could. But there wasn't anything on the external examination to indicate, other than that one scar that we couldn't explain, to indicate torture. Most people are familiar with bedridden people. It takes a lot of care and a lot of consistent rotating and conditioning of the skin to make sure that you don't have skin breakdown. So I'm sure that he had to have round-the-clock care. All five doctors in this office had a discussion on what do you think could be gained by doing an autopsy in this particular case, considering we believe the insult to him or the severe damage, the what happened to him happened over a year before he came here. And we felt like nothing significant was going to be gained from an autopsy, and we honored the family's wishes. The family is looking for answers, but at this point, we're never going to know unless the people that were there at the time it happened come forward and say, this is what happened to Otto.